Good morning to everybody. Today I would like to teach you an English story of a narrate written by Leo Tolstoy. Before teaching a story, I would like to tell you about author as well as summary of the story, that is three questions. Let us know more about writer. Leo Nikolaevich Tolstoy was born in Russia on September 9, 1828. He served in the Russian army from 1851 to 1856. He was a nobleman who owned a great lead of land, much land, but felt it was his duty to give it away and lead a simple life. He came to be a firm believer of non-violence. As you know, our father of the nation, that is Mahatma Gandhi, was greatly influenced by his writings or works. His tales give a true picture of the life of the Russian peasants. He doesn't tell a story merely to amuse us. He is teaching us a lesson. Over the last 30 years of his life, Tolstoy established himself as a moral and religious leader. As you know, Anna Karenina and War and Peace are his immortal works. Tolstoy earned much name and fame in his life. Tolstoy reaped the rewards of international acclaim. Our beloved writer and social worker died on November 2019-10. Okay? Let us see summary of the story, three questions. As you know, three questions is a thought provoking story of Leo Tolstoy. Once there was a curious king wished to know the satisfactory answers of his three questions. The three questions that occurred to him were as follows. What was the right time for everything? Who was the right person to talk to and whom to avoid? Last one, what was the right work to do? These are the three questions that occurred to the king. In the hope of getting the answers, the king announced throughout his kingdom that he would give a great reward to anyone who would tell him the satisfactory answers of the mentioned questions. All learned men came in the court of the king, but they all answered his questions differently. In reply to the first question, some of the wise men suggested proper planning of days, months, and years. Others declared that it was impossible to decide beforehand the right time for every action. Some others said the king should have council of wise men and magicians could know the right time for every action. Some said counselors, priests, doctors were the most important people. In reply to the third question, some of the wise persons suggested a skill in warfare, science, religious worship, etc. Unfortunately, their answers didn't satisfy the king. So the king decided to consult the hermit lived in the wood, was renowned for his wisdom. But it was the quality of the hermit. The hermit used to receive none except the common people. The king went there alone and dressed like a common man, leaving his bodyguards and horse behind. When the king approached, the hermit was digging earth in front of his hut. On seeing the king, the hermit greeted him and went on digging. On seeing the physical side of the hermit, one can guess or one can think that the hermit was weak and frail. The king went up to him and said that he has come to ask him to answer of his three questions. The hermit listened to the king but answered nothing and went on digging the ground. The king realized the hermit is tired. The king took his spade and worked a while for him. Means, I mean to say, the king was sympathized with him. He showed his sympathy for the king. Again, we see the king went on working for the hermit. The king, while digging, put his questions, but the hermit didn't answer them. Soon, what was seen? A man with a bleeding wound in his stomach came running to him and fell fainting on the ground. Without knowing any identity, the king bandaged his wound and took every care and gave him fresh water to drink. Meanwhile, the sun had set. The king, with hermit's help, laid him on the bed. The king, as you know, the king was very tired and slept on the threshold. As you know, the king was not habituated of sleeping in the jungle, in the open area. But we see, in the hope of getting the answers, the king had to stay there. As the king was very tired and slept on the threshold, when the king awoke in the morning, he saw that the wounded man, lying on the bed, pleaded him for his forgiveness and gave him information that he was his enemy who hid in the bush with an intention to kill the king for executing his brother and for seizing his property. He also told the king, when the king was on the way back home, he wished to kill him, but he couldn't get success. It was because the bodyguards of the king recognized him and wounded him. The king took, as we see, the king took every care of him and he was saved. The king forgave him. As you know, the king was very generous. His generosity is seen here. What generosity is seen here? That is, he forgave his enemy and gave him his own physician and servants to look after him. And the king returned his property. When the king asked the hermit his questions again for the last time, the hermit told him that He had already been answered. He said the important time was when the king was digging bed for the hermit. Otherwise, he would have been attacked by the bearded man without making peace with him. Hence, the most important time was when we have power. I mean to say, present time is under our control. The most important time is with whom we are. And the most important work is to do good to others. Let us see moral of the story. Moral of the story is that all human beings are born or have been sent into this life for doing good deeds. Love all selflessly without any selfish motive, and the concerned person must help one another in the time of lurch. There has been much importance of present time that can be controlled by us. Present person with whom we are and present good deeds done in the interest of mankind. It is rightly said that service to man is service to God. Thank you.